severe weather. It's the power of Mother Nature. There's still so much to be known about the fury unleashed upon us. Storm spotters and storm chasers, one of the first lines of defense, are out there keeping an eye on malicious weather. Some wonder why I became a spotter. Well, let me start with one of the initial events that directed me towards that goal. Woodward, Iowa, November 12th, 2005.
The worst thing I've ever seen. I never want to see anything like this again.
It wasn't like one of those cute funnel clouds, you know, with the tapered end, you know? It was just this big honking, wide, angry looking wall of wind.
I just heard this big, huge, just a gust of wind, and then I just felt my house move. I felt it, and it threw me out of bed and threw my dogs out of bed.
You know, this is the first thing we saw.
No one ever thought they'd see this in November.
Yeah.
That's for sure.
It's amazing what our professionals did here in this community to protect it, save it, to guard our people.
I hadn't seen tornado damage like that in person myself. I thought I saw approximately 8 houses just destroyed immediately as I came into town.
Our job is to get the word out before the tornado hits, and we really hope that people heed our warnings.
And continue to watch it head north over Donna Howe's house and over Heather Fusen's house. It took the third one up there, and then we watched it head toward town, which was really sad because there's nothing you can do about it.
Just like Rod Chalk said, it's a miracle.
It's a miracle.
I got hurt.
Now this TV was on entertainment center, and this 2x4 came from somewhere. And we have no idea. I mean, I don't know if it's from my house or anybody's house, but it was shoved up into that TV.
Huh. Jackie Seaman was suddenly awakened by the tornado. Just like many in this town, she's thankful to be alive.
My family, that it's just unbelievable. I just love them so much.
After my hometown was hit by a tornado, I rapidly developed an interest in this phenomenon.
You alright?
I'm okay. Here, we're actually on the main street, and Eric, as he mentioned, they're blocking this main drag off. As I step out of the way, you can see down the street, the road is blocked. Right now, it looks like they've set up some sort of a point. We've seen Dexter fire, we've seen Adel fire, we've seen Urbandale fire, and Clive and Polk County come into town.
The dogs went around each of the areas of destruction, and they didn't hit on anything. So as of Sunday morning, we were really well relieved that there wasn't any injuries or deaths in the tornado.
And, I left the office and got on 141 and followed a state trooper in here at fairly high speeds. And by that time, there was a stream of traffic of people coming out to see what had happened to our little city. I just was anxious to get here and to be involved in what I needed to be doing as the mayor. And
a chance to meet Toby. This is a guy whose picture was on the Des Moines Register without a house.
Okay,
he just wanted to say thank you on behalf of the citizens. So.
I don't know if I speak for everybody, but at least for this little guy and me, I appreciate it. Words don't express how I feel for everybody's generosity. It just means a lot to me. I have a new appreciation for life, I'll say that.
November tornadoes are extremely rare. And to have a November tornado, you need a pretty good push of warm air. I would have to go back and look at some of the meteorology to try and figure out what that day was. But I do remember it being very windy, and it was warm. and we had a cold front coming in, and we had a big system pulling up, big area of low pressure pulling into the state as well. And it was adding a little bit of spin to the atmosphere, but we weren't expecting a big tornado outbreak. We thought, well, we may see a couple of very quick spin-ups, but we're not expecting a big tornado outbreak. Well, the ingredients started to come together, and as the thunderstorms developed, they developed in an area that was prime at that point for some tornadoes. And obviously, the one in Woodward was a pretty good-sized tornado.
I want to tell you, you guys did an awesome job. You portrayed our city and our community in just a fantastic light. You didn't create hysteria. We had things like, some of you probably don't know this, our water supply was dysfunctional for 24 hours. And the news media could have got a hold of that and just made hysteria. And they respected our needs, and Brian Gilbert directed them. And they really deserve a round of applause for the way they handled this.
For the folks of Woodward and Stratford, know that Midland Radio out of Kansas City and KCCI News Channel 8 will be providing you with a gift coming up in the next couple of weeks. And John McLaughlin will be in town, I believe, handing these out to each and every one of you. I believe we're going to be working on weather radios, and we are very excited. Again, I don't want to give too much information out.
Like
it's amazing what our professionals did here in this community to protect it and save it and to guard our people.
Maybe I'll be good. Pray for me.
And they have a new outlook on life. Really do.
Interruptions, because we don't want stuff like this to happen. And if we have no injuries coming out of Woodward, I'd say that it was a job well done.
Iowa City, April 13th, 2006. I was still dealing with the Woodward tornado aftermath. It just seemed like the tornadoes were following me. Now it was my college town.
As you can see, the power is out. There's no electricity in downtown Iowa City.
I was just blocks away from where this one did the most damage. National Weather Service had issued a high-end F2 rating for this one, which means winds just above or around 150 miles an hour.
Basically, I was standing on my deck, and I was looking up in the sky, and all of a sudden I seen this cloud coming. The wind just started roaring and stuff, and my ears started popping, so I ran downstairs, and when I was walking downstairs, my main door flew open, and you could see all this debris flying, and like it looked like this cloud, all this debris flying everywhere, and I ran downstairs, my ears were popped, and came back out like probably 10 minutes later, and this everything was just destroyed. My car window was broke, and tree branches everywhere, and fire trucks everywhere. And
The Woodward and Iowa City tornadoes both were similar in their wind speeds. Some would even argue that the Woodward tornado showed some signs of F3 damage.
Said I just got here, and it is kind of weird looking at St. Patrick's Church. I went to Iowa City, Regina in seventh grade, and they used to have the St. Patrick's Grave over here where the parking lot is now. And so we used to practice basketball in that school, and then we'd go to Mass at that church every now and then. And man, that's an old church. It sure is. It's kind of hard to look at it like that. But I think this is going to be an interesting trip through my old hometown.
Yeah.
Spent the first 25 years of my life here, and a place that is really near and dear to my heart. And, you know, it's kind of hard to see it like this, see people walk around like this and stuff. So.
Rain is coming down.
little bit ago and come down about an inch every 45 minutes.
Of a severe thunderstorm warning in effect until 10:45.
You'll see such as we have never seen before. As predicted, we are experiencing unprecedented threats to our campus and our community, and our resolve and our collaborative spirit will be both required and tested.
Massive floodwaters closed that stretch of highway for many days. The Des Moines River swarmed the entire river valley, covering both eastbound and westbound lanes.
Where are you guys from?
Ogden, just up the hill.
Okay, have you guys ever seen flooding this bad before?
I was down here in 93 and it was about like this.
The road was barred off, but didn't stop people from parking on it, which later the barriers were moved up and no parking signs were also put in place.
You can see from this location, the water goes out as far as the eye can see. This is Highway 210 and it's about to be threatened again to be covered by water.
Eastern Iowa, Cedar Rapids, and Iowa City were hardest hit. University of Iowa was also forced to close down several buildings on campus.
Thank you for coming. We have comments today regarding the critical flooding situation facing the University of Iowa on this from President Sally Mason.
Thank you all for your help, your support that you provided so far, and please respond to this dangerous situation with as much patience, fortitude, cooperation, and assistance as you can.
And going beyond that. So we are in uncharted waters in terms of being able to respond to a flooding event of this magnitude. And the spirits remain high, but the pace is frantic.
And this has been a Klein Studios special, Look Back the Iowa Floods of 2008. The Dixie Alley Outbreak, Birmingham, Alabama, April 27, 2011. We were in eastern Mississippi when we got word of massive tornado outbreak, and we're heading towards it, actually.
Fire and rescue, turn around, come here.
You get to get some national news coverage too, because there's just storm after storm, and each of them producing very powerful tornadoes.
Mother Nature is just trying to make sure that me and Eric just take our time.
Tuscaloosa just got slammed with a severe, violent tornado. We're heading towards Birmingham, coming from the northwest. We were in the middle of it. Some were already passing behind us.
From I-65, and the tornado is just massive. I mean, there is just like a cloud on the ground.
Tornadoes, and we've worried about this for days, and we're afraid that this would happen, and sure enough, we've had that this evening up in West Pont, and you might be getting some debris falling from
the branch down.
Down to the south of there, but again, it will be moving steadily northeast. We'd advise nobody traveling on Alabama Highway 5 between Brent and West Pont. So let's go to our storm northeast of Birmingham. The storm clearly has lost some of its structure, but that doesn't mean that it's not dangerous. Just saw a Twitter report of a tornado on the ground on Blackjack Road in St. Clair County.
While driving by Birmingham, we see medical personnel invading the city. We knew this tornado outbreak was historical. We just didn't quite yet know how many people lost their lives. According to the National Weather Service, Dixie Alley outbreak, which consisted of April 26th through April 28th, 2011, had over 140 tornadoes, of which approximately 12 were EF4.
Oh my god.
And approximately 2 of EF5. That means winds closing in excess of 200 miles an hour. Enhanced Fujita. Final death count came in at over 300 people.
Historical storms that we just drove through, I don't think anybody thought they were going to be that bad, not even the locals, so. Reminds me of the hometown when that hit my hometown, Woodward, that was back in 2005. Everybody walked away pretty much, just maybe bumps or scratches, but nobody died in our town.
Unfortunately, it couldn't have done that here.
Yeah.
Joplin, Missouri, May 22nd, 2011.
Right, we're headed down southbound on Schefferdecker Avenue, Joplin, Missouri. April 6th, Saturday, 2013. About 2 years, almost, and next month, 2 years since the Joplin May tornado, 2011. West 26th and Schefferdecker. Ponds, little locations, probably full of debris. You can see the tree snappings, and trees are still bare.
I wasn't there for this event, but this was another historical tornado event. I felt the need to go there and at least visit and see how the recovery is doing.
Yeah. Okay. Westbury Square. In Joplin, a bunch of houses were rebuilt through here.
The Joplin fatalities totaled around 160 people. The National Weather Service had ranked this one an EF5, excess winds over 200 miles an hour.
I'm kind of following the tornado's track now as we're going east. Further into Joplin and the business district into town, Rangeline Road, where the Pizza Hut and some other businesses were that were taken out or destroyed during that day.
Some had described the destruction as looking like an atomic bomb went off in Joplin. Things were not recognizable. And some of the people in Joplin, just like any town in the Midwest or Tornado Alley, would tell you that during the springtime and summer months, it's very common to hear tornado drills and tornado sirens going off. Ignoring them can prove fatal, but also some people heeded the warnings and did the right thing as they thought at the time. But how do you hide from 200 plus mile an hour winds? Tire foundations are sweeped clean. Classic EF5 damage.
Salt bare area where houses are.
An example of this destruction comes from the security cameras from Joplin High School. Thank you.
some people are rebuilding, some people are not. They're not yet.
A fellow filmmaker from Joplin actually documented the Joplin event.
A free documentary event comes to Joplin for one night. Friday, May 11th at 7 p.m. at Taylor Auditorium on the MSSU campus. A story of distress, survival, recovery, and hope.
Hi, I'm George Norrie, host of the nationally syndicated Coast to Coast AM. Make sure you're part of the documentary, Joplin, Missouri. You don't want
to. We're on 20th Street here. Also another heavy hit area. Home Depot that was destroyed has now been rebuilt. Same with the Pizza Hut. Walgreens.
The visit to Joplin was very emotional, but a good reminder that, yes, Mother Nature has its beautiful side, but also its dark, devastating side.
We just put it into the Magellan here, and it brought us to the location. We had found it completely by accident, and so it's kind of eerie that we found it.
And this is why storm chasers, storm spotters, scientists, meteorologists, everybody's teaming up together to help with the warnings, to better warn and protect people.
Hi, I'm Storm Spotter. Actually, I have two codes here, one for Polk County, one for Boone County.
There looks to be pea-sized hail right now.
And now you know why I'm, still to this day, an active storm spotter.
Don't get